Welcome to Manipati. In this video, we will discuss about support and resistance. These are one of the most important concepts in technical analysis. The reason is it is related to psychology of traders. If you remember, in the fundamental principles of technical analysis, I said history repeats itself, and also explained how psychology of traders helps history repeating itself. Support and resistance are the technical terms to denote the psychology of traders. So you can think of these as price points at which history will repeat itself. I discussed about support and resistance briefly in that video, and I will cover it in detail in this video. Now let's understand this with an example. This is Nifty 50 chart, monthly chart, and I have shown point A, B and C in the chart. So if you see the point A, this point and this point, after price reaches this point, it went down and then climbed at this point, and again it went down. So this is a resistance level. Like most of the traders think that if price will reach point A, then it will decline. So most of them try to book profit. They try to sell it. That is the reason price comes down when it hits point A. Now here, point A is breached, price has moved up, then it came again to that level, and see, the price has again moved up from that level. Briefly, here also you see it is the same A point. Here price moved up, then again came down to that level and price moved up. So at point B, the same resistance level is acting as a support. Now it might sound confusing, but this is the reality. Support becomes resistance and resistance becomes support. So what is occurring is, so here the psychology was that price will not breach this point, and when price reached that point, it fell. And here the price was breached and again it moved up, then again at the same point it was breached and moved up. So at this point B, traders are thinking that price will not sustain below it. You see here a small area for maybe 2 or 3 days, 4 days, price was below it but it zoomed up. So they have a understanding that price will not move below A. Now price has stabilized at this level. So when it came to point B second time, or let's say I think it's fourth time, it started zooming up. So people think that, oh no, it is the base price of the Nifty at this point of time. So support became resistance. The same support at point B again became resistance at point C. You see here, it went up to this point and then fell, and again it reached to that point. So it keeps on happening. Support becomes resistance and resistance becomes support. Resistance means price will come down after reaching that point. So price, if price is moving from below, for example, if something is trading at 100 and 150 is the resistance or support, or the price from which it comes down, then if price is moving from 100 to 150, then 150 will become your resistance. And if price is coming from 200 to 150, then 150 will become support. So it's the direction of price movement defines the term support and resistance. Support and resistance are the price points where the script changes its direction of movement. So in this chart, you can clearly see A, B and C. These three are same price point, but acting as a support and resistance at different point of time. Understanding this basic concept is very important for technical analysis. And I will, in this video, I will also show you how to apply the support and resistance concept of technical analysis for making a trade. One more thing I will like to highlight. See here, 10,000 point price point, and see again at this point. So when Nifty came back here, it zoomed. So it's acting as a support, and the same here. So if price zooms from a point, right, it rebounds from a point strongly, then it is a strong support. So 10,000 is a strong support for Nifty. Now, it brings to three important questions. First, you might have heard analyst and everyone saying that trade in direction of the trend. So first assumption in everything is trade will continue, trend will continue. Now, if you are into trading or if you have seen the price movement, you might be aware that trend does reverse. Anything does not go up and up and up or down and down and down. It goes up and down, up and down. So trend will reverse. And strength of levels, how strong is a support or resistance? So here, let's see. So this is the uptrend and this is the downtrend. So trend is reversing. What happens is, based on news or events, trend gets reversed. So you might have seen some people saying that we don't care about news. What we only care about the charts and technical analysis. But this is partially correct. No chart will tell you about impact of an event. It can't. For example, let's give me a recent example of corporate tax rate cut. No one predicted at Friday 10 a.m. there will be announcement of corporate tax cut. And Nifty, Bank Nifty will zoom more than 5%. It can't be predicted by charts. So events have the power to reverse the trend. And you should always keep in mind if there is any event which may have a major impact on the trend. Basically, if you can predict if it's a positive event or negative event, then good. If not, then it is advised to avoid event days. Support and resistance are broken. The second point, trend will reverse, and strength of levels. Now, support and resistance are broken. It is not that it won't be broken, it is broken. Suppose if Nifty is in a bullish mode, look here, Nifty is in a bullish mode. It has moved from this point and up till May, it's a huge movement of 500 points. So Nifty is in bullish mode. At that point, it breached the resistance at point A. So if underlying sentiment is bullish, then resistance or support will be broken. Like if bearish, then support is broken, and if bullish, then resistance is broken. Always take care of this fact while making a trend. Suppose it's a bearish mood, then you can assume that supports will be broken but resistance will be respected. And if it's a bullish mode, then you can assume that resistance will be broken and support will be respected. So that will help you like make more profit while trading instead of always trading based on support and resistance. You should also take into consideration the direction of price movement, whether it is bullish or bearish. Third is strength of levels. As I told you, more strongly price bounces from a point, more resist like strong the support is. And also volume is also very important. See, Nifty is an index, so you can't see the volume here. But if you look at this point, market just touched it, strongly touched it and boom, 100 to 200 points. Same here, touched and boom, 100 to 200 point. So 10,000 is a very strong support area for Nifty. And all other point, if you see, those are not that strong. So strength, you can simply assume that the stronger a price bounces from a level and the more time it bounces from a level, stronger is the support. So here two times it has bounced from 10,000 level. So 10,000 is a strong support area. Now I will also show you an example trade as I referred earlier. So this is a Nifty Bank. Just to a word of caution before sharing it. This example trade of mine is shared to make you understand support and resistance concept and how I used that concept to make a trade. I repeat, you should understand the concept and then apply it for your trade. You should not refer whatever I have shown here in the chart because it's an old chart. And the support and resistance levels may have changed as of now. So you should understand the concept. You should not imitate the trade what I have done. Now with that warning, now this level, this is a resistance level. If you look at this point, after reaching this point, Bank Nifty has came down significantly. So it acts as a strong resistance. And now here also you see price moved up but it came down strongly. So it's a resistance level. So looking at the graph, it is clear that it's a resistance level and a strong one. So what should I do? It's an example of option trade. So if you are not familiar with option trading, just to understand what I am saying. So here, if a price point reads here, my action was to sell it, sell Nifty Bank, because it's a resistance area. Now what I did is, in the option terms, I bought put of 1,200 at 250. The price, option price was 250. So total money I invested was 5,000 only, as lot size of Nifty Bank is 20. Now I sold the same at 650. So bought at 250, sold at 650. So my total profit was 8,000. So I invested 5,000, I got 8,000. So profit percent is 160%. This is what happens if you trade based on the correct levels. If you I traded at this point and I got somewhere around this point, like this is the support, it was broken that day, but it might have been respected the other day, or this point 31,200, it might also have been respected here. So just take care of making a sale or buy call at right price will give you a handsome profit percentage. This is just an example trade. And this is the report of my bought and sale and the amount of profit I made. It's a July series. So far in this video, you have learned the concept of support and resistance and how you can use it to make a trade. And you should understand the direction of script is very important, whether it is bullish or bearish. And if you have established the direction of the script or index and applied support and resistance concept, then it will be a fruitful trade. Now that's it in this video, and I will be posting further videos on technical analysis course. This video is also part of technical analysis course, so I will be posting more videos both in Hindi and English. And to receive notification about new video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel Manipati, or you can visit manipati.com. To subscribe, you can click on the subscribe button below the video to receive notification about the new video. If you click on the bell icon, it will notify you whenever I post a new video. Thanks for watching the video. One more disclaimer, I am not SEBI registered analyst, and whatever I am sharing in this video is based on my own learning through trading in the stock market. So thanks for your time. Bye and happy trading. See you in the next video.